My name is Simon Moore, and welcome back to Let's Play Farming Simulator 17, Episode 41. And today, I have no clue what we are doing. But we have acquired a new mod, which I hear is very good, so I'm just gonna take their word for it. Okay, and then let's go here. This is weird. Not that button, this button. Helper settings, left shift. Sure, turn angle 50% and land off. Okay, now let's refresh field. Okay, now let's try. Fireworker. I don't get this. Okay. Oh well. We can do this ourselves. Because that is very annoying. Speaking of very annoying, my parents right now. I thought that one was just a partial one, not a full one. Oh well. I'll just pick that up later. I need to get some more American style hay rakes. Although I have seen a style of like the really small one that's in the game. In like New Holland or something like that. I don't remember what brand it was, but I've seen like two or three of them. So yeah. You kidding me? This is why I don't do this. This is why I hire somebody to do it. Offset. 1 meter. We'll go with 1 meter. On. Show traces off. Pause off. Connected field only. Off. Collision check on. Wait during off, manual steering on. Let's see if that works. Okay. Ah! Tire work left. Auto steer on. Ah. Nope. Why does this not work? Watch the difference. I don't like the inverted arrow keys. Those are annoying. Those are real annoying. But anyways, yeah, this is, I don't know what's up with this. It's getting just a little bit annoying. There we go. Let's go to manual steer off. Manual steer. Auto steer. Auto steer should be on. There we go. Did they miss a row as well? Oh well. Oh well. After this video goes up, or yeah, this video will go up on Sunday most likely. Hopefully, then on Monday. I'll be able to talk to the person that suggested I get it and see how they use it and find out how they use it, because that's just a little bit annoying. I'm happy that I've finally gotten back into recording at least normally. I'd like to get to uploading 2 videos a day, but that's not gonna happen. I do need to get some stuff done on Minecraft, but oh well. The next video that I have planned is going to be very interesting. And I have no clue how it's gonna work. Ooh. Oh yeah, then things can just despawn. So I'm thinking about building a gold farm, and 100% on the poll was yes to build it, or yes to use creative to break bedrock. Because the one thing required is a dragon egg, and I have not made it to the end yet and defeated the ender dragon. Yeah, Ender Dragon. But if I did, then I'd have an Elytra. Or an Elytra. Whatever it's called. And then I'd probably have Shulker Shells. Because that'd be the first thing that I'd go to the end to do. So yeah, I need to work on that. Okay, let's go figure out if me just popping in here. Automatic engine start on. Okay, then why is he? Let's turn it off. E. Enter. I should probably actually have that on. But I do not. And we'll just start over here for once. So I got to thinking between the recordings of last episode and this episode, and I came to the conclusion that if I used, wait, is that a 3-point hitch? That if I bought the Vulture, that's $50,000 more than the John Deere, then I can do the tethering at the same time as the mowing. But if I did that, then that'd be $50,000 more if it is a 3-point hookup. And it is. Unless somehow there's enough horsepower on the front of that John Deere that I can hook this up to the back. Wait, this is how I... Nope, wrong. Ooh, let's go back to the front. There we go. Yep, we're gonna have to do some measurements here. And where's everything? Tethers are... Okay, so this one is 6 meters. That's 12.5. Well, why? Probably end up getting that one. Modes. That's 8.4 meters wide. $42,000. So we need $10,000 more, and then we'll just buy that. Wait, how much? What's the horsepower requirement? 160. And then our John Deere that we need to get is the load. Where's our tractor that has 160 horsepower? 138. This has 140. Are you kidding me? T6, 143. What did I say it was? It was 160. So 127. This thing to get it up to 138. No, Don's not powerful enough. $165, that'd be $129. Don's $127. We're gonna go for the cheapest one. So this is $120 for this. Then get the upgrade, it's $128. So $190 to $209. I don't think they're gonna do that. We'll just set up and be rear twins, most definitely. With the 7430 and then front loader attacher, most definitely. So it's gonna be like $121,800. I mean, we could always do this one. And it has 868 horsepower for $65,000. But it goes 19 miles an hour. But that'd make one great road train. with an articulated tractor and 5 or 6 trailers. That sounds like a lot of fun. Anyways, let's get back to what we were doing before I got sidetracked. And that'd be picking up all this mowed grass. We also need to buy a really small trailer. I don't know how big it needs to be. It doesn't need to be overly big. For manure hauling. That'll be something that we need to get into is manure hauling. 6666. Quad sixes. Once we get enough manure, I am going to sell it. Stay on track. There we go. Once we get enough manure, we're gonna be decently rich. Because I can... buy an auger wagon or something. To use to put it into to haul from the old cows over to the biogas plant and then if we get some pigs that'll be another bit of stuff. Well, right now, in my great state, it is the busiest time of the year. It's basically wheat harvest, and it is June 24th. Wheat harvest usually starts around July 4th, or around the beginning of July. It's starting almost 10 days early. I know some people that should have started already, but they haven't. And I know some people that are started already. Because they can't go golfing with me. So, yeah. Speaking of golf, I need to upload some more golf vlogs. See how well that goes over. Yep, pick it all up. I wish that this stuff sold for more, but oh well. I've not been on Minecraft in like a couple of weeks. That's probably May when I was last on Minecraft. Jeez, it's been nearly a month. There's no more of it. So put that and race to the other end of the field and start picking up this and head back. and dump it into the silo. Those types of silos, like I have here, are more common in my area than, like, the bunker. Although I have seen one or two bunkers in my days, but I've seen more of the silos than bunkers. Oh, I forgot that I was gonna go unload. Oh well. I wouldn't mind getting some more, or getting a bigger forge wagon, but oh well. I will be getting some new mods eventually, because I gave somebody some of mine and they're going to give me some of theirs. Copying them. It's legal. There's no copyright laws. It's just so that they don't have to download, they don't have to look for them. It's the easiest way to do it. Don't have to look for them, and it's really easy. Because you have to search for certain things, and yeah, sometimes can be a little bit of a hassle. But oh well. Everything is just fine. Yeah. One of them is a livestock trailer that requires a fifth wheel, so that means that I have to put another mod in this save game, which will be my Chevy 2500. Pickup can have like the max horsepower of 400 horsepower, and it costs like maybe 50 grand for that. But that should be interesting. Because if I can haul 100 cows at a time, that's $500,000. No. Yeah, that's $500,000 worth of cows right there. That'll make your herd reproduce pretty quickly there. I want that. I want to have 100 cows in one load. Although, probably when you go to sell it, you're gonna have a little bit of a hard time getting up that hill. Although, yeah, the easiest way to actually take care, well, you don't lose out on any money when you go up and sell them there, but you lose out on a little bit of money when you're selling them. I think that if you buy two pigs, it takes, maybe they have to reproduce like three times, I think, to make a profit to actually make a profit. So once you actually get enough pigs, they will pay for themselves eventually. Wait, no, they cost half as much, or they sell for half as much, So if you buy two, that's, what is it? Maybe $1,000, I think? Maybe, no, it's not $500. It's maybe $1,000 a piece. So that'd be $2,000, then they sell for, wait, no, they sell for 250. So you have to have, you have to reproduce 8 times with those 2 pigs to make, to start to make a profit. So if you just have 2 pigs, you will eventually just, you'll eventually start turning a profit. Let me see here. Okay, so 86 plus 8, that'd be 94, so we have to get it up. Oh no, I'm probably just going to end up filling it up most of the way. We're filling it up all the way because that thing can hold 45,000 or 47,000. And I can just start filling her up. And trying to make a profit there. We're actually going to see where the best price is at for silage. Because I'm not against leasing things, but I don't particularly care for it. But it'll, wait. Oh yeah. This thing is going to fill it up completely. Okay, so we need to start to fast forward time just a little bit. We need to get the New Holland hooked up to the trailer. I believe I did my math correctly. So that puts 92 and 10, so yeah, 102%. Then, where's it at? Where are the prices good at? Okay. So we sold it at the barn last time. Ooh. Looks like it's gonna be good at the barn again. Why is this tractor always on and it's just burning diesel as it goes? Let's go with R. Well, this thing's not gonna fill up completely. It's not gonna become full. This thing unloads incredibly slow. So it's gonna stay at about 17 to 18,000 liters. Full at a time. Okay. Actually, escape. 9:57. Would this thing just shut off for once? I probably don't know how to shut off. Oh well. This is gonna be fun to drive. There she fails, and we are about to take off. Jeez, this is going down fast. We might actually have to lease that auger wagon. Nope, not F, E. Is it still 850? Jeez. Oh. No, we can't make this one higher. Oh well. Oh yeah, we might need to go clean the cow and sheep areas. Oh well. My word, this thing struggles just a little bit. Anyways, we're making quite a bit of money. $72,000. Okay, now where's that? That 849. What in the world is that? I should try and just do an all vanilla game where there's no mods, just straight up doing it legitly. And see how well it goes. fill this thing. Just shut off! Shut off, man. You're getting a little bit annoying. Anyways, ooh, let's actually go over 2 hours. This is where Case is at. And our planter. Oh yeah, get to set up that great course play course for this field. Ooh, yeah. It's at 31%. I really need to invest in a desktop computer because it should be running better than this. I need a better graphics card. Hands down. The only problem is, where is Simon going to get the $1,600 for the computer that he wants? Oh my. Most definitely not having days off of work. That's where he's not gonna get it. Now, if I worked every day, then yes, I would probably be able to afford it. Although I do have nearly 2 months of work left, and I've worked right around 80 hours in the first month. First 4 weeks, whatever. So, yeah, I guess I might be able to. Depends on how much I get paid per hour. Per hour. Eight times nine is, oh geez, I don't even do math anymore. Eight times nine is 72. 720 if I get paid $9 an hour. 800 if I get paid $10 an hour. Halfway in between that, 720 and 800, that'd be $80 difference, so it'd be 760 if it's 9.5 an hour. Or I don't even know how many hours I've worked exactly. Yeah, we want to do it this way. Go here. Okay, you can shut off now. Okay, I should be able to refill it now. E. Can I go R? Okay, 7:45 or 8:45, yeah, I guess. This is going to be another long episode, just like episode 39. Because I'm going to sell all the silage in this video, and then I am going to do what else I need to do. Wait. If I get 31 grand on this one, then I'll be up to 103 grand, and then that means that after the harvest, then I should be able to buy the tractor. I should be able to buy the John Deere. And then that means that we can sell the little Hurleyman tractor. That's not worth anything. At least to me. It's worth, like, zero money to me. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 112! I am $8,000 off. Okay, where's the little Hurleyman? This thing's going bye-bye. This thing is going bye-bye. And I need, what, 21.8? 121.8, I think. Okay, so escape. 844, yeah, we'd probably better get that thing on reset. Yes. Okay. Enter. What now? Ooh, nothing good. So I need just over 9 grand for this thing. Or right at 9 grand, or just under. Or just under 9 grand is what I need. But I'd like to get 10 or 11 from it. To give us just a little bit of wiggle room. So let's go R. $25,000. Yes. Sell, please. Yep. P. Tractors. Okay. This one? Or should we go for the one? Oh, then we're $3,000 off. Wait, what's the difference? This one starts at 220. This one starts at 203. 20,000. Yes, we'll start out with this one. We'll set up rear twin duals. And that. Bye. Yep. Okay. We got our 8430. We have our 8430. Wait, no, it's a 7430. Not an 8430. 7430. Hey. At least this one goes 32 miles an hour. Now we don't really have. Well, now that this is our most powerful tractor, we're gonna be doing quite a bit of stuff. Ooh, jeez. Oh, that's really badly done. Let's see if we can. Yeah, yep. These things need cleaned up. Let's see if we can do this. Wait, let's see if we can do it in cab view. We should be able to. Really? We have to reset it because I reset the case. Oh, wow. Reset. Yep. Now we have to go find the arms and reset those. Yep. Okay. I love this tractor already. Even though it's not, like, the best thing, It's better than 88 horsepower. It has over 188 horsepower. I don't know if we're gonna end up upgrading this engine or not. They need to get a John Deere front loader for this thing. Like the front loader attachments for John Deere, that's what they need. So then it actually looks really good with this tractor, not just meh. Although, it does look a little bit weird with the twin duals on the back, but hey, it works. I could have saved $1,000 and not got the duals, but the duals make it look better. Yes, they do. I think that the way that they've set this up is kind of stupid. That once you bought them, it doesn't cost anything to take them off, but then it costs you another $1,000 to put them back on. I think that you should buy them once, and then you should just be able to take them off and put them back on whenever you want, without any charge. I had a mod, or I probably still do have the mod from 2015 where I basically had, I bought duals for it, and you could have duals on the front and back, or just duals on the back. And that made the tractors look pretty cool. With them duels. Okay, now we need to get the little New Holland on something. I think he needs to be on, I don't know what he needs to be on. Let's actually get it. Get this thing out of here. Get out of here. Yeah, we're gonna make just a little bit of money here. This episode yet. Just a little bit more. Not enough to get us what we want. Definitely not enough to get us the mower that I want. But, oh well. What can the pickup do on this farm? That one's not big enough to pull this trailer. Although I wish it was, because then we could have this thing on the mower. Something. I don't know. Now we can invest into an auger wagon. Or even a semi. Okay. Back it up just right. R. Now, if we can just back it up straight. R. This isn't gonna fill up much. Let's actually see how much is in the... just over 5 or 6 that, just around $5,000 or 5,000 liters. Run. Well, I've got a whole nother load of, or enough to fill up this thing again, at least for liquid fertilizer. I'm glad that somebody actually was smart enough to know that you put liquid fertilizer in a planter, not solid fertilizer. That one kind of missed Giants' head just a little bit. Giants' head. Or their heads. Just a little bit. Okay, now. Let's actually use something powerful now. I'm sorry. You've been demoted. To what? I have no clue. But not to selling duty. You're still not good enough for that. Oh yeah. Where's the sunflower prices? The soybean. Ooh. Holy crap. That's high. 2.5 per ton. We're gonna get like a full trailer of tons, and that's gonna be a lot of cash for us. Just to put this into perspective, that's gonna be enough for us to buy a semi along with our, we don't need a semi though. Semi wouldn't hurt. Oh no, we might end up getting the massive road or the. How? Do you? What? The duals are too wide to fit through here. It's the stupid bucket on the front that's causing all the troubles. Wow. That's great. Now. What? Now we're just gonna set up for the harvest, which we're going to do in the next episode. Sorry guys, I would do it in this episode, but this episode's getting just a little bit long. But I hope you guys have enjoyed this, and I'll see you guys in the next video.